This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Phonology is a branch of linguistics concerned with the systematic organization of sounds in languages. It has traditionally focused largely on the study of the systems of phonemes in particular languages and therefore used to be also called phonemics, or phonematics, but it may also cover any linguistic analysis either at a level beneath the word including syllable, onset and rime, articulatory gestures, articulatory features, mora, etc. or at all levels of language where sound is considered to be structured for conveying linguistic meaning. Phonology also includes the study of equivalent organizational systems in sign languages. Contents 1. Terminology 2. Derivation and definitions 3. History 4. Analysis of phonemes 5. Other topics in phonology 6. See also 7. Notes 8. Bibliography 9. External links. Terminology. The word phonology, as in the phonology of English, can also refer to the phonological system, sound system of a given language. This is one of the fundamental systems which a language is considered to comprise, like its syntax and its vocabulary. Phonology is often distinguished from phonetics, while phonetics concerns the physical production, acoustic transmission and perception of the sounds of speech. Phonology describes the way sounds function within a given language or across languages to encode meaning for many linguists. Phonetics belongs to descriptive linguistics, and phonology to theoretical linguistics. Although establishing the phonological system of a language is necessarily an application of theoretical principles to analysis of phonetic evidence, note that this distinction was not always made, particularly before the development of the modern concept of the phoneme in the mid-20th century. Some subfields of modern phonology have a crossover with phonetics in descriptive disciplines such as psycholinguistics and speech perception, resulting in specific areas like articulatory phonology or laboratory phonology. Derivation and definitions. The word phonology comes from ancient Greek phone, phone, voice, sound, and the suffix logy, which is from Greek logos, logos, word, speech, subject of discussion. Definitions of the term vary. Nikolai Trubetskoy in Grundzüge der Phonologie 1939 defines phonology is the study of sound pertaining to the system of language, as opposed to phonetics, which is the study of sound pertaining to the act of speech. The distinction between language and speech being basically Saussure's distinction between langue and parole. More recently, Last 1998 writes that phonology refers broadly to the subdiscipline of linguistics concerned with the sounds of language, while in more narrow terms, phonology proper is concerned with the function, behavior and organization of sounds as linguistic items. According to Clark et al. 2007, it means the systematic use of sound to encode meaning in any spoken human language, or the field of linguistics studying this use. History. The history of phonology may be traced back to the Ashtadhyayi, the Sanskrit grammar composed by Panini in the 4th century BC. In particular, the Shiva Sutras, an auxiliary text to the Ashtadhyayi, introduces what can be considered a list of the phonemes of the Sanskrit language, with a notational system for them that is used throughout the main text, which deals with matters of morphology, syntax and semantics. The Polish scholar Jan Baudouin de Courtenay, together with his students, Mikołaj Kruszewski and Lev Sherba, shaped the modern usage of the term phoneme in 1876-7, which had been coined in 1873 by the French linguist A. de Friche Destinets, who proposed it as a one-word equivalent for the German Sprachlaut. Baudouin de Courtenay's work, though often unacknowledged, is considered to be the starting point of modern phonology. He also worked on the theory of phonetic alternations, what is now called allophony and morphophonology, and may have had an influence on the work of Saussure. According to EFK Corner Nikolai Trubetskoy, 1920s, an influential school of phonology in the interwar period was the Prague school. One of its leading members was Prince Nikolai Trubetskoy, whose Grundzüge der Phonologie, Principles of Phonology, published posthumously in 1939, is among the most important works in the field from this period. Directly influenced by Baudouin de Courtenay, Trubetskoy is considered the founder of morphophonology, although this concept had also been recognized by de Courtenay. Trubetskoy also developed the concept of the archiphoneme. Another important figure in the Prague school was Roman Jakobson, who was one of the most prominent linguists of the 20th century. In 1968, Noam Chomsky and Morris Halley published The Sound Pattern of English SPE, the basis for generative phonology. In this view, phonological representation notations are sequences of segments made up of distinctive features. These features were an expansion of earlier work by Roman Jakobson, Gunnar Fant, and Morris Halley. The features describe aspects of articulation and perception, are from a universally fixed set, and have the binary values or minus. There are at least two levels of representation, underlying representation and surface phonetic. Representation-ordered phonological rules govern how underlying representation is transformed into the actual pronunciation. The so-called surface form, an important consequence of the influence SPE had on phonological theory, was the downplaying of the syllable and the emphasis on segments. Furthermore, the generativists folded morphophonology into phonology, which both solved and created problems. Natural phonology is a theory based on the publications of its proponent David Stamp in 1969 and more explicitly in 1979. In this view, phonology is based on a set of universal phonological processes that interact with one another, which ones are active and which are suppressed as language-specific rather than acting on segments. Phonological processes act on distinctive features within prosodic groups. Prosodic groups can be as small as a part of a syllable or as large as an entire utterance. Phonological processes are unordered with respect to each other and apply simultaneously, though the output of one process may be the input to another. The second most prominent natural phonologist is Patricia Donegan Stamp's wife. There are many natural phonologists in Europe, and a few in the US, such as Jeffrey Nathan. The principles of natural phonology were extended to morphology by Wolfgang U. Dressler, who founded natural morphology in 1976. John Goldsmith introduced autosegmental phonology. Phonological phenomena are no longer seen as operating on one linear sequence of segments, called phonemes or feature combinations, but rather as involving some parallel sequences of features which reside on multiple tiers. Autosegmental phonology later evolved into feature geometry, which became the standard theory of representation for theories of the organization of phonology, as different as lexical phonology and optimality theory. Government phonology, which originated in the early 1980s as an attempt to unify theoretical notions of syntactic and phonological structures, is based on the notion that all languages necessarily follow a small set of principles and vary according to their selection of certain binary parameters. That is, all languages' phonological structures are essentially the same, but there is restricted variation that accounts for differences in surface realizations. Principles are held to be inviolable, though parameters may sometimes come into conflict. Prominent figures in this field include Jonathan Kay, Jean Lowenstam, Jean Roger Vergneau, Monique Charette, and John Harris. In a course at the LSA Summer Institute in 1991, Alan Prince and Paul Smolensky developed optimality theory, an overall architecture for phonology according to which languages choose a pronunciation of a word that best satisfies a list of constraints ordered by importance. A lower-ranked constraint can be violated when the violation is necessary in order to obey a higher-ranked constraint. The approach was soon extended to morphology by John McCarthy and Alan Prince, and has become a dominant trend in phonology. The appeal to phonetic grounding of constraints and representational elements, e.g. features, in various approaches has been criticized by proponents of substance-free phonology, especially Mark Hale and Charles Rees. Broadly speaking, government phonology or its descendant, strict CV phonology, has a greater following in the United Kingdom, whereas optimality theory is predominant in the United States. An integrated approach to phonological theory that combines synchronic and diachronic accounts to sound patterns was initiated with evolutionary phonology in recent years. Analysis of phonemes, an important part of traditional, pre-generative schools of phonology, is studying which sounds can be grouped into distinctive units within a language. These units are known as phonemes. For example, in English, the p sound in pot is aspirated pronounced, while that in spot is not aspirated pronounced. However, English speakers intuitively treat both sounds as variations, allophones of the same phonological category, that is of the phoneme p. Traditionally, it would be argued that if an aspirated were interchanged with the unaspirated in spot, native speakers of English would still hear the same words, that is, the two sounds are perceived as the same p. In some other languages, however, these two sounds are perceived as different, and they are consequently assigned to different phonemes. For example, in Thai, Hindi, and Quechua, there are minimal pairs of words for which aspiration is The only contrasting feature: two words can have different meanings, but with the only difference in pronunciation being that one has an aspirated sound where the other has an unaspirated one. The vowels of modern Standard Arabic and Israeli Hebrew, from the phonemic point of view, note the intersection of the two circles. The distinction between short a, I, and u is made by both speakers, but Arabic lacks the mid-articulation of short vowels, while Hebrew lacks the distinction of vowel length. The vowels of modern Standard Arabic and Israeli Hebrew, from the phonetic point of view, note that the two circles are totally separate. None of the vowel sounds made by speakers of one language is made by speakers of the other. Part of the phonological study of a language therefore involves looking at data phonetic transcriptions of the speech of native speakers and trying to deduce what the underlying phonemes are and what the sound inventory of the language is. The presence or absence of minimal pairs, as mentioned above, is a frequently used criterion for deciding whether two sounds should be assigned to the same phoneme. However, other considerations often need to be taken into account as well. The particular contrasts which are phonemic in a language can change over time at one time, and two sounds that have the same place and manner of articulation and differ in voicing only, were allophones of the same phoneme in English, but later came to belong to separate phonemes. This is one of the main factors of historical change of languages as described in historical linguistics. The findings and insights of speech perception and articulation research complicate the traditional and somewhat intuitive idea of interchangeable allophones being perceived as the same phoneme first. Interchanged allophones of the same phoneme can result in unrecognizable words second. Actual speech, even at a word level, is highly co-articulated, so it is problematic to expect to be able to splice words into simple segments without affecting speech perception. Different linguists therefore take different approaches to the problem of assigning sounds to phonemes. For example, they differ in the extent to which they require allophones to be phonetically similar. There are also differing ideas as to whether this grouping of sounds is purely a tool for linguistic analysis, or reflects an actual process in the way the human brain processes a language. Since the early 1960s, theoretical linguists have moved away from the traditional concept of a phoneme, preferring to consider basic units at a more abstract level. As a component of morphemes, these units can be called morphophonemes, and analysis using this approach is called morphophonology. Other topics in phonology: in addition to the minimal units that can serve the purpose of differentiating meaning the phonemes, phonology studies how sounds alternate, i.e. replace one another in different forms of the same morpheme allomorphs, as well as, for example, syllable structure, stress, feature geometry, accent, and intonation. Phonology also includes topics such as phonotactics, the phonological constraints on what sounds can appear in what positions in a given language, and phonological alternation, how the pronunciation of a sound changes through the application of phonological rules, sometimes in a given order, which can be feeding or bleeding, as well as prosody. The study of suprasegmentals and topics such as stress and intonation. The principles of phonological analysis can be applied independently of modality because they are designed to serve as general analytical tools, not language-specific ones. The same principles have been applied to the analysis of sign languages. See phonemes in sign languages. Even though the sub-lexical units are not instantiated as speech sounds, see also absolute neutralization. Chirology. English phonology. List of phonologists. Also category: phonologists, morphophonology, phoneme, phonological development, phonological hierarchy, prosody, linguistics, phonotactics, second language phonology, phonological rule notes. Carrot A. B. Lass, Roger, 1998. Phonology: An Introduction to Basic Concepts. Cambridge, UK, New York, Melbourne, Australia, Cambridge University Press. 1 ISBN. Carat A. B. Trubetskoy N., Grundzüge der Phonologie, published 1939, translated by C. Baltax's Principles of Phonology, University of California Press, 1969. Carat Clark, John, Yallop, Colin, Fletcher, Janet, 2007. An Introduction to Phonetics and Phonology, 3rd ed. Massachusetts, USA, Oxford, UK, Victoria, Australia, Blackwell Publishing. ISBN. Carrot Hale, Mark, Reese, Charles, 2008. The Phonological Enterprise, Oxford, UK, Oxford University Press. ISBN. Structure of Language, Readings in the Philosophy Language, pp. Approaches to Phonological Theory, pp. Jakobson, Roman, 1949, On the Identification of Phonemic Entities. Travaux du Cercle Linguistique de Copenhague, 5-205-213, doi:10101080-0105-020-619491041-6304. Sapper, Edward, 1933. La Réalité Psychologique des Phonèmes. Journal de Psychologie Normale et Pathologique 30-247-265. ASL Arabic Modern Standard Egyptian Levantine Tunisian Avestan Belarusian Bengali Bulgarian Catalan Chinese Mandarin Cantonese Old Historical Czech Danish Dutch Standard Oorsmal Gussenhoven Dialect English Australian General American Regional North American Received Pronunciation Old Middle Esperanto Estonian Faroese Finnish French Quebec Frisian West Galician German Standard Bernese Chemnitz Dialect Colonian Greek Standard Modern Ancient Koine Gujarati Hawaiian Hebrew Modern Hindustani Hungarian Icelandic Inuit Irish Italian Japanese Kiowa Konkani Korean Kyrgyz Latgalian Latin Latvian Limburgish Hamit Lithuanian Luxembourgish Macedonian Malay Maldivian Marathi Navajo Nepali Norwegian Occitan Odia Ojibwe Old Saxon Oromo Ottawa Pashto Persian Polish Portuguese Proto-Indo-European Romanian Russian Scots Scottish Gaelic Serbo-Croatian Slovak Slovene Somali Sutu Spanish Spanish dialects and varieties Swedish Tagalog Tamil Taos Turkish Ubique Ukrainian Upper Sorbian Uyghur Vietnamese Welsh Yiddish Zuni Authority Control GND, 4045836-2 NDL, 0056888-0.